Trigonometric functions are special functions whose domain is angles and whose range is ratios of sides within a right triangle. Now the first thing we need to do is figure out what angle we're going to look at to plug into our trigonometric function. If we call this angle theta, then we can label the sides like this. Opposite angle theta is the opposite side. Adjacent to angle theta, so right next to, is adjacent. And finally, the longest side is the hypotenuse. Now you may be thinking, how do we tell the difference between the adjacent side and the hypotenuse? Well, the hypotenuse is always opposite the right angle in a right triangle. But opposite and adjacent can switch places depending on where you place theta. What if instead we placed angle theta down here? With theta down here, the opposite side is this one. Next to it, the adjacent side is down here. The hypotenuse is still the hypotenuse because it's across from or opposite the right angle. When we compare these two triangles, we see how the placement of theta depends or can alter where our opposite and our adjacent side is. So here's the first three trigonometric functions. If you plug in whatever angle theta is into the sine function, it gives you the ratio of the opposite over hypotenuse. Plugging it into the tangent function gives you the ratio of the opposite over adjacent side. And finally, plugging it into the cosine trigonometric function gives you the ratio of the adjacent over the hypotenuse. Other than these three trigonometric functions, there's three more. So here we have the three we learned about, sine, cosine, and tangent, and here's the new ones, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. If you look at these closely, you may notice a relationship between sine and cosecant, between cosine and secant, and between tangent and cotangent. They're reciprocals of each other, meaning cosecant is just a flipped over fraction of what sine is. There's two special triangles you learned about in geometry. The 45-45-90 triangle is the right triangle that has 45 and 45 degrees as the other two non-right angles. The relationship between the sides and the lengths of the sides is each leg is the same, which makes sense because they're opposite the same angle, and the hypotenuse is rad 2 times the length of the leg. So if this leg measured 1, this one would also measure 1. And 1 times rad 2 is just rad 2. With these measurements, we can now evaluate the trigonometric functions for 45 degrees. Let's look at this 45 degree, although it doesn't really matter. Now, sine 45 degrees is the ratio of the opposite side, this 1, over the hypotenuse, this rad 2. So sine 45 degrees is 1 over rad 2. Now, you may remember we usually don't like radicals in the denominators of fractions. We have to rationalize them. So after rationalizing this, we end up with rad 2 over 2. Next, let's find the cosine. Cosine of 45 degrees is the adjacent side, that's this 1, over rad 2. So actually we end up with 1 over rad 2 again, which when we rationalize is rad 2 over 2. Now let's find the tangent of 45 degrees. Tangent 45 degrees is opposite over adjacent. So 1 over 1, well, that just equals 1. Now, knowing that the other trigonometric functions are simply reciprocals of these three, we can evaluate them fairly quickly. Cosecant of 45 degrees is 1 over rad 2 flipped over, which just ends up being rad 2. Secant of 45 degrees is also rad 2. Tangent 45 degrees is 1, and the reciprocal of 1 is just 1. I'm sorry, this is cotangent. Now there's another special right triangle, the 30-60-90. Here the relationship between the shortest side and the hypotenuse is double the shortest side. And the longer leg is rad 3 times the shortest side. So if we make this shortest side 1, the hypotenuse would be twice 1, which is 2, and 1 times rad 3 is simply rad 3. Now we can find what sine 30 degrees is. So if 30 degrees is our angle and sine represents the opposite over hypotenuse, sine 30 would be 1 over rad 2. Let's find cosine of 30 degrees. Cosine of 30 degrees would be adjacent over hypotenuse, which is rad 3 over 2. Let's also find tangent of 30 degrees. Tangent of 30 degrees is opposite over adjacent, 1 over rad 3, which after we rationalize ends up being rad 3 over 3. Now what's neat about the 30-60-90 triangle is not only can we evaluate the trigonometric functions at 30 degrees, we can evaluate them at 60 degrees as well. Like, let's find sine 60 degrees. Now we're interested in this angle. So opposite 60 degrees is rad 3, and the hypotenuse is 2. So sine 60 degrees is rad 3 over 2. Cosine 60 degrees would be adjacent over hypotenuse, which is 1/2. And finally, tangent of 60 degrees would be opposite over adjacent, which is rad 3 over 1, so just rad 3. You could find the reciprocals of all of these to evaluate the other three trigonometric functions. But not all the triangles we're working with are special 45-45-90s or 30-60-90 triangles. Let's look at this example. Here we have to evaluate the six trigonometric functions of the angle theta. So we see the angle theta there, and we actually only know the length of two of the sides here. This side is 5, and this side is 12. Well, we can actually use Pythagorean theorem to figure out what the length of this side is. A squared plus b squared equals c squared, where c is the length of our hypotenuse. So 5 squared is 25, 12 squared is 144, and we end up with 169 as the sum. To figure out what c is, we take the square root of the 169, and we find out that the length of c is 13. Now we're ready to evaluate the six trigonometric functions. Sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. So sine theta is 12 over 13. With cosine theta, we look at the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So we have 5 over 13. Tangent theta, opposite over adjacent, we have 12 over 5. And using the reciprocals of our first three trigonometric functions, we can evaluate the second three. Cosecant's the reciprocal of sine, so cosecant of theta would be 13 over 12. Secant of theta is the reciprocal of cosine, so we'd have 13 over 5. And cotangent's the reciprocal of tangent, so we'd have 5 over 12. And we've done it. We've evaluated all six trigonometric functions for angle theta in this triangle.